Everyone, this is Success Dale, just back again. This time doing one off the recommendation of a friend, Doc3825, who thought this would be a good idea, but I gotta say, gotta fucking agree with him. I'm talking about a movie from 1996, The Frighteners. Again, as I mentioned, The Frighteners came out in 1996, starring Michael J. Fox. Yep, Michael J. Fox on Back to the Future, as well as Spin City and other things. As Frank Bannister, a kind of con man, you know, he's kind of like an exorcist, a ghost hunter, you know. He's seen as a con man in his local town. Not quite though, because, you know, in order to get set up cons, he gets the help of spirits. So he is actually like a spirit medium, he does see the supernatural. The Frighteners was made by Peter Jackson and Noah, who go on later to make Lord of the Rings and things like that, and The Hobbit. But anyway, Frank Bannister, he's got the true sight after he and his wife were involved in an accident. The wife was ultimately killed, left him with this gift, but of course, you know, he kind of lost his drive as well, his happiness at that point. He was an architect at the time, he built a greenhouse, and when that happened, when she died, everything just went to hell. He didn't know the person in the house, he just scraped by as he is. He's helped, of course, in his, you know, his job by three ghosts, a sort of like 1970s kind of gangster called Cyrus, a kind of nerdish, you know, from, guy from the 50s called Stuart, and an old west cowboy called the Judge. Of course, with the new people coming into the town, Frank pulls his normal job, but in doing so, he notices something very unusual about his woman's husband. It's kind of like spectral writing on the guy's head, marking him with a number, which freaks out Frank, and when he dies, everything starts to come together. You know, all the people are being murdered with these spectral numbers by what can only look like the Grim Reaper. Frank, of course, tries to intervene and is drawn to a sort of complex plot regarding this spirit and trying to track down who the hell it is, what it is, why it's at it. Unfortunately, he's being sort of like tracked or investigated by like an FBI special agent called Mountain Drummers, who's played by Jeffrey Combs of the Reanimator franchise. The story itself, once Frank and his friends investigate it, find this Reaper is actually like a serial killer from like a number of years ago called Johnny Bartlett, who kind of went on a fucking mad killing spree, caught everyone that he killed, he was cut in a little bit differently, they marked them like the numbers 1, 2, 12, that sort of thing. And the only way for them to get rid of him, they need to try and see them and then exorcise him to properly get rid of him. Unfortunately, Bartlett wasn't alone, and he went on his kill spree. He was actually assisted by Patricia Bradley, his kind of girlfriend, who were led to believe is innocent of all crimes up to this point. Bartlett, Patricia, Frank, they all are practically sucked into the light of whatever's beyond this world. But Frank comes is set back while Patricia and Johnny are sucked into fucking hell. Well, they deserve it, actually. Overall, this is a great film. It's a lot of fun. It's great to see Michael J. Fox. I just love Michael J. Fox and everything. He's just very enjoyable on screen. It's a good film. It's got its scare moments, it's got its bits of humor. It's got that side of kind of vibe. It didn't do well, you know, financially at the time, but it has, you know, it did get good reviews, and it's got like cult status, you know. It's like one of those fan favorites, you know, you enjoy this film. Well, I would check it out, enjoy it. Again, Frighteners and Michael J. Fox, not a bad show. Should definitely watch it this Halloween. I've been Success Dale. Thanks for watching.